not put an actual work video up for a while, but that's just down to where we're working. So on this job here, we are replacing the boundary protection and then replacing the line protection. So I'm just going to see if I can reverse the camera while we're talking, and I'll show you what's going on.
So incoming main, we've replaced the boundary protection double check valve, put in a drain cock, we've then got a branch off here. This is going to the production line. That's going to have a fluid category 4 backflow preventer on, which is an RPZ valve. We've got another production line going here. That's also got an RPZ valve on it. It's going out to production. And then up here, it carries on and it's a potable line. So that one there feeds the domestics, and then that one feeds the emergency showers into the factory. That's Tom and Matt. Right, so we have down at the bottom there, double check valve, drain cock. What did you say, Matt? We've then got us two process lines here, which is these two, pressure reducing valve and then RPZ valves. Got some waste to go on them. Got another pressure reducing valve there, because that's the equipment that's critical. Can't exceed 10 bar, so pressure reducing valve set to 3.5 bar, and then we've got an expansion relief valve, which is set at 6 bar. Matt's just pinging laser up because we've got to come off this T now and go on to this ABS, which we just need to get cleaned up. And get that old RPZ valve up there removed, which is not in an accessible place for testing, servicing and maintenance. They are a good valve, that type. It's a Watts 009 from USA. But we'd need to bring everything down at low level, so we fit some Honeywell, now known as Resideo, Brockman or something like that. So that's it. You just keep your fingers away from it, Tom. Okay, Matt.
Set your jaws up and then you'll have it wobbly around. So, tell us when you level it, Paul.
Yeah, I remember.
Okay. Pretty good thing.
Wait there 1 second, just wanted to pull it up. That's it.
A bit of movement anyway.
Yeah, I've got movement. That's why I won't bother about that getting pressed in. So on this job, we have replaced the boundary protection, which is that double check valve there. Then we've got a drain cock, we've cut out some dead legs. We'll branch off here, we're just in process of lagging for a process line into the factory. We've got a pressure reducing valve, RPZ valves, we're then carrying up. We've actually got it on bypass at the moment, so that's a bypass. And come back to this, so we've carried on up. We then branch off again for another process line in factory, so again we've got pressure reducing valve, RPZ valve. And this one's closed off because we've got the bypass open. So the bypass is actually protected by an RPZ valve, and then we carry on this pipe work up and we go back onto existing services. I don't know if you noticed, when we originally on the first part of this video, they were on some M10 rod. That's just because we didn't have any cantilever arms, so they've gone in now. There's another pressure reducer involved there. There's a 6-bar expansion relief that goes via a tongue dish, and then they're all just getting linked together. This is actually what the job looked like before we started. So just above stop tap there, centre shot now where I'm touching, that's the double check valve. The one no drain cock, albeit the what oh nose union bib tap that you could drain from, but that actually introduces a risk into this area because somebody can then attach a hose and it's an unprotected supply. There's quite a large dead leg there, small dead leg there. You've got your RPZ valve here. That pressure reducing valve there had a date on it of 2004, which is absolute bonkers. So we just carry on up here. And actually the other RPZ valve is located right up near the ceiling height, but there's lots of obstructions in way here. So one of the questions you can ask when you come to servicing, testing and maintenance is it readily accessible for servicing, testing and maintenance? And the answer is up there, no it ain't. And you can see there that we've got the bypass on, which is in centre shot now. So that bypass is protected via this RPZ valve here. So both process lines are supplied by the RPZ valve, and it's got a bypass which allows you to test one, open up the bypass and keep water flowing into the factory. So that is before we started. And if I go to the image afterwards, now we've completed all those works, which I will choose. I'll probably choose this one actually. That's as complete. That's probably not the best one actually. Let me go back one. I think I have got a shot that's further away. Matty there posing. Loves his job, does Matt? Is this a better one? Yeah, that's a wider angle. So we've just brought everything down. There were an expansion relief valve on that original shot, but it didn't have an air gap. It just went straight to outside and into a gully, so you couldn't see if it were discharging, and also no air gap for backflow protection. So we look for a conspicuous discharge and an air gap to provide backflow protection. That is it. Job complete, customer happy, the water authority happy. If you need any RPZ valves, testing, servicing, maintenance, installing, give us a call. Thank you.